All right, guys. What is going on? Yep, I'm back, and obviously you guys are gonna tell me that. How many times you gonna do the live stream? I did it before as well, like an hour ago. But again, there's some YouTube problem going on right now that my live stream was not really on my channel after I'm done all this stuff. So probably I'm gonna have to do this live stream again. So you know what? We're just gonna talk just a bit quick now because I'm really tired. I just did live stream. I'm doing again. I'm kind of tired now. So let's talk about the match now. What's gonna do? What I'm not gonna do? So first, gonna be show intro, of course. Then it's gonna be the first match, the Shield versus the Usos for the Tag Team Championship. Then we're gonna have Curtis Axel versus the Miz. Then Ryback versus Chris Jericho. And then we're gonna have six. I guess I can seven man ladder match for the SmackDown, which probably is a seven man, but I cannot do seven in the W13. So we're gonna play as a six. We're not gonna play as Antonio Cesaro. And then after that, we have the World Heavyweight Championship match. Dolph Ziggler versus Dolph. You know, not Dolph Ziggler, it was Dolph Ziggler. Dolph Ziggler versus Alberto Del Rio. Sorry about that. Then we have the seven-man ladder match again. But probably Kane is out, so we're gonna play as a six-man. Then we have the last and final main event match, Cena versus Mark Henry for the WWE Championship. So, how about we start the show now? And yeah, those of you who just came, like, you know, you guys did came in. You know, watch my live stream before, like an hour ago or something. But after the live stream was over, I went to my YouTube channel and check everything, and it was kind of not working fine. So I decided to do the live stream again. I'm a bit tired, but I'm still gonna do it because it's awesome to do it. Yeah, so far. So of course we have the first intro for sure, and there will be no game sounds. Sorry, but I'm not allowed to do it, so there will be no game sound for sure. You won't have it. You won't even be able to hear my commentary on all the this video because I don't want anything to happen this time. I want my live stream to be all right this time. So yeah, sorry about that. First match we're gonna have, I mean, the first match we're gonna have is the Shield, Seth Rollins and Roman versus the Usos, Jimmy Uso and Jey Uso. For the tag team championship, it's gonna be pre-show. It's not gonna be on pay-per-view. It's gonna be pre-show, which is pretty shit. But I'm still gonna have to watch because you know the Shield is awesome right now. So probably I'm gonna watch. So you know what? This time you're gonna cut. I'm just gonna cut the entrance. I mean, we saw their entrance like a million times. It's kind of a different. I should do like a tag team entrance, but probably I can't do it now. I'm gonna leave it like that. And yep, Jimmy Uso's. All right. I saw your entrance like 100 times, so don't want to see it again. All right, those of you can I mean, watching right now, can you please leave a comment and tell me is everything working fine? Can you see the gameplay, and can you hear my voice? And what was that white thingy? I don't know. All right. Oh, that's the Mike Tyson entrance, I guess. Yeah, I think it is a Mike Tyson entrance, and yeah, I downloaded him from W13. You know, all that crap is not in W13, but you can download him. Go find SmackTalks, something web. That's a website you can find him. So it's gonna be tag team championship match. Why it always takes so long? I don't get it. That's always something go fucking wrong with it. All right, I don't know what's wrong with their. Oh, it's black again. I don't know, something wrong. All right, they both have the same entrance. What the heck? All right, I didn't get it. But probably we'll start the match now. But please, if you are watching right now, please leave a comment about this match. Please leave your prediction about this match. What do you think? What's gonna happen in this match? So yeah, let's start it. All right, this takes so long. I don't know why. Taking so long. All right, the first match, tag team championship match, Usos versus the Shields, Seth Rollins and Roman. And my prediction for this match, first of all, I'm gonna say why the heck they have this match in pre-show. I mean, they are Shield, okay? Whether you like it or not, but they are kind of really good right now. Even though I don't believe in the Shield, I don't even like them. But probably they are really good in wrestling skill, and everything is perfect about them. But probably this match should be in a pay-per-view, not in a pre-show. I mean, they should have Kurt is excellent. The Miz in pre-show instead of this match, because I would love to see this match in a pay-per-view, not in a pre-show. Leave a comment below about if you agree with me that do you think this match should be in a pay-per-view, not in a pre-show. I don't know why. It's just my thought. So probably. So again, my prediction for this match is gonna be that Seth Rollins and Roman to retain the title, the Shield to retain the title, and not drop the title against the Usos. Now, why am I saying this? Because they won't really drop the title against them, and probably the YouTube. You know, they don't really give any championship in the YouTube pre-show. I think I know someone won. It was a United States Championship or a Santino Marella or something, and someone won. I don't know. Yeah, it was Antonio Cesaro who won the U.S. title on pre-show. It was really good, but probably I don't see this match that they, you know, they're gonna give away. I mean, they're gonna drop the title. So probably why I'm, I know you guys are gonna say that a couple of weeks ago they kind of beat the Shield by, you know, 3-on-3. Christian and Usos versus the Shield. They kind of beat the Shield, you know, Christian with a spear to Dean Ambrose and kind of beat them. I mean, even Cena, Sheamus, and Ryback couldn't beat them, but they did, which was kind of weird. I like they're all super. I mean, Ryback, Cena, and Sheamus are kind of like bigger than Christian and Usos, but they still couldn't. They didn't beat the Shield, and Usos and the Christian. It's kind of weird. I don't know why, but probably I don't know. Leave a comment. Do you think Jey Uso's deserve to be number one contender for the tag team, and do you think they will win the tag team championship? Leave a comment below. And yep, again, if you came right now, this is a live stream of WWE Money in the Bank 2013 prediction show, not a real pay-per-view. Those of you just come here to see the live and real show. It's not a real show. You can read the title, it's a WWE 13 prediction show, not a real show. Even the thumbnails are not real, it's a game. You can see it. So yeah. And please, if you just if you watched my stream earlier, it was the same kind of stream like this, but at the end of the stream, I don't know, something went wrong. I'm into my channel, something was fucked up. I don't know what happened, so I have to do this live stream again. So probably I'm really tired, but I'm still doing the live stream, guys, because I want to do live stream. Yeah, so probably it's gonna be fun. I think so. I'm not sure. I don't know how long this match is gonna take to finish. I put it as a normal. The mode is going to be normal, so I don't know how long it'll take. But probably it'll be good. So please, if you're watching right now, leave a comment. What do you think? Who's going to win this? Is it going to be the Usos who's going to be the new tag team champion, or is it going to be the Shield who's going to retain the title? I don't know, but you guys can leave a comment about that, because I have no idea what kind of prediction should I give for this match. As I said, I want to see this match in a pay-per-view, not in a live stream. All right, I think it's kind of gonna take a bit long. I don't know why. All right, guys, I'm trying to read the comments at the same time, so you know. All right, let's talk about the match now. So again, if you are watching, please can you leave a comment if you can, if there's no any problem with the live stream, could you please let me know in a comment below so I can go ahead and fix that if there's any problem. I hope so. There's no problem so far. So yeah. All right, I guess there's no problem. That's why you guys not even comment. So again, leave a prediction about this match. Do you think the Shield gonna retain the title? And as I said, I think they will retain the title. Now I have no idea why do I think they will retain, but somehow I just have the feeling that they will. So probably they will. Now I don't know, the Dean Ambrose are gonna come out and gonna help them, cause I don't think they do. I mean, they will have gonna come out, cause he got a match as well at the Money in the Bank ladder match. Probably I think they all should be in the ladder match instead of it's only one guy who's in the Money in the Ladder match. It's the Dean Ambrose for the SmackDown. So probably, I mean, you know what? The best thing the Shield can do is right now separate all of them and let's see how tough they are in the one-on-one match. I want to see Seth Rollins versus, I don't know, Daniel Bryan, I guess, say that, because they're both, I mean, they had a match, I guess, at SmackDown. So probably I want to see Seth Rollins versus Daniel Bryan one-on-one match, and I want to see Roman versus I would say Ryback. Let's see, because they're both kind of a big guy. They're probably epic, you know. Oh shit! Super kick to Seth Rollins. Is it over? Is it over? I guess. Oh no, he kicked out again. So again, if you're watching, please can you Leave a comment about this match. Do you think that the Usos is going to be the new tag team champion? Or the Seth Rollins and Roman are going to retain the title and not going to drop the title for like I don't know how long? And there's other news about Shield and the Kane and the Undertaker stuff. If you don't know, I'll try and put the news about it. The Undertaker might return at SummerSlam and teaming up with his brother Kane. And take out the Shield at SummerSlam, probably. I don't know, that was a news, that was rumors going on that Taker to be returned at SummerSlam before WrestleMania 30, because he will be at WrestleMania 30 as well, but we might see Taker at SummerSlam. So leave a comment below, do you think Undertaker gonna return at SummerSlam, or it's just a news, or it's just a fake news? I don't get it, but I was reading earlier today. Taker to be returned. I don't know. It'll be epic if it's Taker return and teaming up with his brother Kane. That's the one way that we can really beat the Shield or something. I don't know why. Well, that's what my opinion is. I don't know. And maybe Taker might not return because we all know that Taker gonna have one more match against John Cena at WrestleMania 30, I guess. Which is I'm not looking forward to see it because I know what they're gonna do. They're gonna end the streak for no reason. I don't know why. So yeah. All right. I don't know what's going on. I don't know how long this match is gonna go. It's already been like 11 something. Please, guys, if you are watching, can you please leave a comment about this match and any other stuff? And please, do you think this match should be in a YouTube? Shouldn't be in like a TV, television? Because they do deserve. I mean, a Shield. Okay, they attack everyone. And one more thing, they do. The good thing is, telling them to attack people. Like, they attack Ryback, Cena, and blah blah. They're all. It was kind of getting bored. So one of the good thing they did is stop attacking people and going on the match and all that stuff, which is epic. And yeah, so maybe I don't know, maybe that's and one more thing, why do I think that Uso might win this? Because they beat the Shield on a 3-on-3, so probably there are chances that Uso do deserve to be the champion as well. If you don't know yet, Uso and Roman and The Rock, they're all cousins. If you don't know, I mean a lot of you do know, I mean kind of all of you knows that Roman is cousin of The Rock, and kind of Uso are son of the Ricky Ciso, and they're all cousin, I guess. I don't know. So let's see. We'll find out tonight at, Payback. I'm not Payback. What the hell I'm saying? You're not Payback. I mean Money in the Bank. I think Payback is still in my mind. I don't know why. Even though it was not that great, it was kind of alright. The CM Punk was a great Jericho match. Was the best. That's why it's still in my mind because he make his return, and you know that I'm a big fan of. Chris Jericho and CM Punk, because my channel is the best in the world, and they both, their catchphrase is the best in the world. I mean, CM Punk is the best in the world, what he, I mean, the best wrestler, best talker, and Chris Jericho is the best in the world, what he do. So probably, yeah, that's why my channel name is the best in the world, because I'm a biggest fan of CM Punk and the Chris Jericho. So yeah. Well, I don't know how long this match gonna go, man. It's like this is gonna be a main event or what? It's still on. It's like been 12 minutes. I don't know what's going on. Come on, someone beat. All right, what's going on? I don't get it. A referee counting five. Oh, that's a glitch. He can't come in the ring. What is going on? Getting in the ring before you get. Oh shit! He's gonna be out. Okay, you see that? Oh, he's in the ring now. That's a really good thing. I thought it's gonna be really glitched. Oh shit, small package. One. Oh shit, he kicked out. He kicked out. Good thing. Good thing. And the glitch was awesome. I mean, not awesome, but I would say shit. If THQ, or I don't know, whoever is on the game, 2K, I mean 2K, if you are watching this, or THQ, you are watching this. Did you see that glitch? What a stupid. So could you please not do that in W2K14? I hope it's something really good in W2K14. You saw the trailer was a really shit one, but I don't know about, Okay, and yeah, guys, I'm not playing as anyone, so I have to make sure my controller don't get off. And yep. All right, I don't know what's going on. I don't know how long this match is gonna go, man. It's like, are they really gonna make this match like this? I hope they do, but probably not knowing it. It's WB. All right, guys. So I still don't know how long this match is gonna be on. I guess I'm trying to check the comments if I have any comments yet, but I guess no, because I don't know why. I think because you guys did came earlier and you saw my live stream, and you guys like why I'm doing again and again. It's not because I want to do like separate. This is gonna be the one, but other live stream had a problem, so I had to do it again, and that's why I'm a bit tired as well. But I'm still doing it, trying my best, do whatever I can. And I don't know how long is this match gonna be on. Come on, finish this. I'm tired. Even you guys gonna get tired of this match. Are they gonna put him to a table or something? Well, it's just not gonna happen in the real pay-per-view. It's gonna be some. Well, I would say not a real pay-per-view, real pre-show, because it's gonna be on YouTube. So don't forget to watch on YouTube, by the way, guys. This is gonna be before like our pay-per-view style or something. And I have no idea what is going on in the match right now. I mean, come on, just get him in the ring and pin him or do something. Just finish the match. We have seven more matches to do. So please just finish the match so we can, finish the show as well. Yeah, I don't know what's going on. All right. This is like a come on. Somebody finish this. Was that a finisher? Okay, I don't get it. Maybe it was kind of finisher. No, it wasn't. Okay. Oh, I think there's a problem with the Roman. He's got a full tattoo on his hand, and it's got like a bit. Okay, I'm gonna change the next time. All right. What is going on, man? Finish the match. We all know the match is gonna be like a 10-minute YouTube pre-show. Plus, I'm not even like gonna watch him maybe because I want this match to be in a not pay-per-view, not in a pre-show. Come on, finish the match. Is he like a Great Khali? Because only Great Khali do that. And kind of Mark Henry, I guess. I don't know what's going on, guys. I'm sorry if you're watching, if you're saying, if this match is gonna take like a 20 minute, how the hell are you gonna finish all of them? Because it's probably gonna take 2 hours then. Oh shit, he's out. Getting in the ring before you get count out, mate. And even they're tagging each other again, again, and again, and again. I don't know what's going on. All right, guys. So if you are watching again, please leave a comment. If you were gonna watch later on, still leave a comment about this match. Do you think this match should be in a pay-per-view instead of really having in a pre-show? Because the Miz was Curtis Axel should be in a pre-show because it's better to have them, have a pre-show. Because the Miz always kind of in a pre-show in YouTube. So I don't know how come this time he's. All right, pin him. Oh God, this is gonna take so long, I guess I can say that. Oh, well, that's from the that's the Rock. I'm kinda confused. You attack your own brother, man. What the heck is wrong with you? And three, there you go. Really? Are they all right? There you go. Jey Uso and Jimmy Uso won the title in the game. Not sure what's gonna happen in the real pay-per-view, but you guys can leave a comment about that. You guys still haven't commented anything. I don't know why. How come? I don't. Did I? I think I did something. That's why. I don't know. I can't see live comments right now. So probably you gotta leave a comment about that. Do you think that the Usos is gonna win the WWE Tag Team Championship? I mean, champions, and they're gonna be the new champion. I don't know. Well, in my opinion, in my prediction, that they're gonna, the Shield gonna retain the title. So probably they're not gonna drop the title. But I don't know. Never know. It's WWE. So let's go to the next match. All right, I don't know what's going on. Still, it always takes so long to load. I don't know. It's all the in problem, taking so long, for no reason. I hope something. I just hope that WWE 2K4 ain't gonna be better than WWE 13. People saying it's gonna be WWE 13 point. I think it's gonna be the same because the graphic looks same. And we saw the trailer, kind of not a trailer. I would say the promo because. We hardly able. I mean, I hardly see like a three or four scene that was like Cena was looking same, Ziggler was the same. Yeah, the Shawn Michaels, the switch in music was kind of a different, which was kind of epic, because he never did that in real life. So how come he wasn't, like, they didn't do it before? I don't know, that was kind of confusing. So again, it's gonna be the IC Championship match, Curtis Axel versus The Miz. Oh, yep. All right. Let me check how long. All right, already been 20 minutes. 3 matches, probably all right. Yep. Again, my prediction for this match is that, am I really gonna watch this match, or I'm gonna go to toilet when this match is gonna start? I'm actually gonna watch this match because of the Curtis Axel, because he's a Paul Heyman guy. Plus, the Miz kind of all right. He's good. I mean, he's not really best. I mean, right now he's a face. People say that he's a really shit as a face. He should be heel again, just like the WWE who turned heel recently at Payback. Probably my prediction with this match is that Curtis Axel somehow gonna retain the title, by getting hell from the Paul Heyman or something. Because he's a Paul Heyman guy, and whoever is Paul Heyman guy, they always kind of cheat and win, which is probably alright, because WWE is not, it's not a real life stuff. Some people just take so serious and like, oh, Cena sucks, Punk sucks, The Rock sucks. Oh, come on, alright? It's all like script. The win and lose all by script. So please, if you are like a 10 or 12, I don't know how old are you, you guys need to calm down and need to understand WWE is an entertainment sport, not a real kind of a sport. It's an entertainment. They're just trying to entertain people. So take it be like easy on it. All right. If Cena wins again and again, there should be some reason behind it. I don't know why they always give Cena like a big match. It's like title opportunity. He's a 13 time champion, I guess, the world champion. 10 time WWE champion, and I think 3 time world heavyweight champion. I don't know, I think 2 time, or I think he's an 11 time WWE champion and 2 time world champion. So probably, I don't know why, but again, my prediction to this match that Curtis Axel to retain the title, because he's not gonna drop against The Miz. The first thing that I thought that Curtis Axel gonna be in the ladder match like a couple of weeks ago, when they didn't announce any of them any matches. I thought he's, he whenever if you are a Paul Heyman guy, for sure you're gonna be the world champion one day. And I thought he might, be in one of the ladder match, maybe SmackDown or Raw, and then he win and he catching and they become the new world champion. We might see CM Punk versus him in the future. I don't know what day, but probably it turned out to be different. It's gonna he's gonna face The Miz at tonight at, Money in the Bank, and it's not gonna be pre-show again. The Shield match is gonna be in the pre-show, which is probably gay, but still we're gonna have to see it. So probably, how did this match, how did the match announce? So probably, if Brock Lesnar attacked CM Punk, and then The Miz TV, The Miz had a kind of segment with the Paul Heyman, kind of ask him, like, does he have anything to do with Brock Lesnar to attack CM Punk? Kind of telling him and all that. Then Curtis Axel interrupt him. He came out and he kind of attacked The Miz, and the match was announced like that, I guess. So yeah. And again, guys, I want to tell you something in this live stream. I'm not doing a Divas matches because I probably don't know anything about Divas. Probably it sucks. They're all good, but it's kind of sucks to watch their match. It's kind of always like a 5 minute and the match is over. So probably no point of doing that. Plus, I only have the AJ Lee in my game right now. I don't have Caitlyn because I can't really find any good because she's not in the game. So she's gonna be in the WWE, I guess. But so again, please, if you like, oh, I want to see the Divas matches, why not Divas matches? They are good. Yeah, they are good. But I'm gonna give my prediction right now because I don't have nothing to talk about this Miz versus the Curtis. So I'm gonna talk about that match as well. AJ Lee versus Caitlyn. My prediction that people are saying that Caitlyn is really pissed off and she's gonna win it, but I would say that AJ Lee to retain her title so far. I don't know why, probably she might get help from the Big E Langston or something, because Big E Langston always with her now. AJ Lee don't really hang out with the Dolph Ziggler anymore. I mean, she do, but not like how they used to do before. So probably I would say that AJ Lee to retain her title or something. And probably she was making too much fun of the Caitlyn and all that stuff. She's really angry. Caitlyn is really angry. But I would, what the heck? The Miz just used Curtis Axel finisher on him. All right. Well, he's still kick out. No point. Oh, I don't know. I don't know how. Yeah, I know you can do that in WWE 13, that you can, use the your opponent's finisher. But that was kind of epic that The Miz did. All right, let's see who's gonna win this match. Cause I did put this match as easy. It's gonna finish. Okay, something came. All right, guys. Sorry about that. One, two. Oh, miss kick. What the heck, man? I put it as easy. Cause, oh yeah, Skull crushing finale, and this is over. He's out. He had a two finisher. He's totally out. But I'm not sure is this really gonna happen. That Miz gonna be the new IC champion. I mean to say Intercontinental champion. So probably I have no idea, but my prediction is that Curtis Axel to retain his title. But you guys can leave your prediction right here in this video, because it's gonna be video after live stream gonna be over. So I hope you enjoyed this match as well. So we're gonna go to the next match, and yep. All right. Taking long again, as always. So next match, I guess it's gonna be, I guess it's, what was it? I forgot. Oh yeah, it's gonna be Ryback versus Chris Jericho. A normal match, single match. And I know a lot of you guys are gonna ask me why there's no entrance music, why there's no game sound at all, because I mute the thingy because I don't wanna, get copyrighted from anyone. So probably it's better if I just, put everything mute. So it's better. All right back. We saw your entrance like a million time. Feed me more, feed me more. He don't even do that anymore. He don't even do that. Feed me more stuff. Now it's a Ryback rules. I love this entrance. Even in the game, he's got the same as he do in the real life. All right. Y2J. All right, guys, right back. Okay, I mean to say cry back versus Chris Jericho. Now, why did I say cry back? Because you're always bitching about it, bitching about it, and bitching about it. Okay, he wanted to be in the ladder match for the WWE Championship. He went to backstage with Ricky Guerrero. Ask her that he put him in, in that match probably because everyone was in the match, and he's like, I'm not in the match. Why? Then, Chris Jericho kind of interrupt. Why would I say interrupt? Rub some them, and then Ricky Guerrero like, how about you two go one on one? Probably that's how the match made. After that, I think Chris Jericho kind of attacked Ryback at Raw or SmackDown. I don't know. It was a Ryback was the match where Ryback got hurt or something, and the match was called off because he was really hurt, and kind of something I don't know something was like that. And then Chris Jericho attacked Ryback with a code breaker, which was awesome because Ryback is a big guy, so the code breaker still work. On Ryback, and I was like, really, can it really work on him? So kind of was kind of awesome to see. So again, my prediction for this match is Ryback to win this match. Now you guys are gonna say, come on, Chris Jericho is the best in the world. I get it, he's the best in the world. Probably, if you don't know, Ryback lost so many pay-per-view matches. He lost to Punk, he lost to the Triple Threat as well, Cena versus Punk versus him. And he lost to Cena at Extreme Rules. He lost to Cena against at Payback. Well, he didn't really lost to Cena at Extreme Rules. It was kind of no contest, but I would still say he didn't want it. So probably same like he lost the match, and then he again lose three stage of hell against Cena at Payback, the last pay-per-view. So I'm gonna say that this match, WWE gonna give him this match, and he's gonna win this match for sure. And now I don't know why I'm saying that, but probably he might. This is just only my opinion, my prediction. But you guys can leave your prediction right now in the live comments below. So yeah. All right. And I have no idea how long this match is gonna go, cause this is gonna be this match. I put it as a normal, so it might be take long, something. So again, leave a prediction if you think Ryback gonna win this match by giving a shell shock to the Chris Jericho, the best in the world. All right. Or do you think Chris Jericho should be in the Money in the Bank ladder match instead of having a match against Ryback? And if Ryback somehow able to beat Chris Jericho, do you think he's gonna get like a big name, like, oh, I beat Chris Jericho, and will he ever able to get another WWE title opportunity, or just he's gonna hang out in the WWE mid card now? Because he had a, like, how many times he had a WWE title opportunity? One, two, three, I would say five times. Wait, two. It's full time, I guess. Full time, he had a WWE opportunity. I mean, WWE title opportunity. He was a WWE title match, but he didn't want. So probably, I don't know if he get big or, I mean, if he beat Chris Jericho, that's nothing gonna happen to him. I mean, probably no nothing gonna make him big. I think he's just gonna hang out at the mid card now. Probably, I don't know. And do you think the last match, the three stage of hell match, Ryback versus Cena, was the best? I would say no, cause in the end, when Cena a right back into the ambulance, you know, from top of the roof, it was kind of really fake, cause I can see the ambulance roof what had some kind of a cross mark, and I think that was where Cena need to put him, cause we all know WWE is a script. They really don't want to get him to the, you know, really injured or something probably. So probably, I don't know. Oh yeah, Chris Jericho got him in the. Oh no, he's gonna tap out. He's gonna tap out. Oh yes, he's gonna tap out. Nope. He's gonna tap out. He's gonna tap out. He's gonna tap out. Oh no, he reversed. He's got a finisher. He might use it. He's already busted open. Shit, he can beat him if you pin him right now. Pin him, man. That's why you always lose right back. Even he. Oh shit, code breaker. Pin him. Pin him. Pin him. Pin him. Pin him. He's out. He's out. One, two, oh shit, he kicked out. Really? Can Ryback even kick out? Like, really? But he's a big guy, but he always, I mean, he lost a lot of matches, so what's the point of saying feed me more? Plus he's a heel now. And do you think Ryback is a good as a heel or good as a face? Because he's a heel right now. He stopped doing the feed me more stuff. Now he's a Ryback rude stuff. And do you think he's a mic skill like, kind of a bit weird? I don't know why I'm saying that. But probably is he just don't know how to talk in a mic, like how CM Punk and John Cena know how to talk in a mic. Ryback, kind of not really great at that, so probably he need to learn that so far. That's why. Oh shit. Oh, failed. Okay, I see one comment. All right. I don't know. I don't know what's going on this right now. Alright guys, if you are watching right now, this is a prediction show, W13, not a real pay-per-view. This show is all about prediction. You guys can leave a prediction here that what's gonna happen in the real pay-per-view. Because real pay-per-view is gonna start tonight. It's not yet live, so leave a comment below. And oh shit, he's gonna in submission. He's gonna tap out. Ryback is about to tap out. And will this gonna happen in real pay-per-view that Chris Jericho gonna make him tap out? Let's see. Oh, he's tapping out, he's tapping out, and there you go, the winner is Chris Jericho. Now, I'm not sure, it's only a game, but, you know, somehow, maybe Chris Jericho may be able to make him tap out. But I don't know, leave a prediction about this match, and any other match, so, yeah. All right, kind of was a long match, I guess. It was not really long, probably. All right, now, we're gonna go to the next match, which is gonna be, I guess, a ladder match. Yeah, it's gonna be a ladder match, SmackDown ladder match. So let's go to the next match. It's always takes so long to load, I don't know why. Alright, the next match is gonna be SmackDown ladder match, which all the superstars are gonna be, they're all young. Well, only one of them have won the World Heavyweight Championship is Jack Swagger. He won once, I guess. And all of them are just, you know, kind of a new. They never won anything big like other superstar. Like John Cena and CM Punk and Sheamus and Randy Orton and Daniel Bryan. Why is taking, oh shit, this is taking so long. It's like, oh, there you go, the show start now. All right, I get it, you got a mad entrance. He's kind of a man the way he walk. Look at him, he's like, ah yes, this is awesome. Okay, I'm just checking the comment, that's what you can hear. I'm checking my laptop as well. Anything wrong with it? Fix it. All right, your entrance is so, let's just go to the. Okay, I don't know what the heck is going on. Who's this? I can't see any entrance. There's probably something. I think it's a glitch. Oh, it's a fandango. All right, good. He looks so kind of real. Okay, whoever did it, a really good job. He's not in the routine. Oh, look at his entrance. I think whoever did it, he used the diva's entrance so far, because fandango is kind of a gay entrance. Probably. Cody Rhodes. All right, guys, I better just, leave the entrance, We don't want to see whole entrance. There's no point, there's no music. Jack Swagger. I wish I could get the new Jack Swagger, because I want to get him, because this is the old one with the spiky hair and some weird eyes. It's kind of a scary. So, yeah. And the beard as well. So probably I wish I could get it, but no point, I can't now. Because he's gonna hit, well, he's gonna be in W2K14, so we will get a new Jack Swagger with his manager. I don't know what his name, I forgot. Yeah, the guy with big mustache and beard and all that crap. Yeah, Damien Sandow. Whatever. Don't want to see your entrance. You're welcome. Wade Barrett. I'm looking forward to see this guy to win the Money in the Bank. I don't know why. I just got a feeling he will. All right. All right, guys, now let's talk about this match. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna talk about everyone. I'm gonna talk about one by one that who what we think about the guy and will he win. So let's start with the Fandango. Okay, Fandango, all the gimmick, Fandango stuff, the gay style and all that. If you don't know yet, the whole idea is by Mr. McMahon. Yep, to make Fandango like that, to entertain people and make something new in WWE. So that was the Mr. McMahon idea, if you don't know it yet, and probably it's all gimmick stuff by Mr. McMahon, which is kind of epic. And if you want to see some funny stuff in my channel, go and check it out. There's a video of 50 finisher on Fandango, which is kind of really good right now. Go and check it out, which is epic, as I said. And so Fandango winning the Money in the Bank briefcase, I would say yeah, but not really. I would say he's got like 40% chance to win this. I can't say like 100%, but probably 40%. Then let's talk about the Damien Sandow. I would say no. No, not at all that he's winning the, that. Cody Rhodes, I would say yeah, because he, not because he will, but I think he deserved to win it, and WWE should give him, because he's been in WWE since a long time, like kind of four, I don't know how long. I saw him first time in WWE in 2008 or 9, I think. So probably he deserved to be, Mr. Money in the Bank. Then we talk about Jack Swagger. I would say WWE won't give him. He can, but he won't give him because he already won once, and he even won the World Heavyweight Championship. So probably nope. Then Dean Ambrose. There are chances that Dean Ambrose might win because he might get help from the Shield. Probably, I don't know how will they help him. Probably somehow, maybe they will be able to help him or something, and somehow he get a win. I don't know. That's just a mild prediction. Never know what's gonna happen in WWE. So yeah. Then we have the Wade Barrett. Now I am gonna pick him. My first pick is a Wade Barrett. Why? Because if you don't know yet, last year Wade Barrett was favorite to win the Money in the Bank. Yeah, he was kind of favorite. Everyone's talking about that. Oh, Wade Barrett gonna win the Money in the Bank, I was reading the news, that's what I'm saying. So he was kind of injured last year, so he wasn't there. So probably this year he will win the Money in the Bank for the SmackDown. And if you think I'm just saying that because I don't have anything else to say, come after like come tomorrow and you will say, oh yeah, Wade Barrett won the thing. Yeah, I'm not sure, maybe he. And my second pick is gonna be Dean Ambrose because he's right now really good. Plus he's kind of, I would say he's not a real the leader of the Shield, but he's kind of he's a leader because look at the Seth Rollins and Roman. They have the tag team championship, but not like a US championship. So that means Dean Ambrose is kind of a leader of them. I would say that, but he's not. So probably time my second pick is him, and my last and third pick is Fandango because I said 40% him to win this. I don't know why, probably. Because if it's a all the whole the Fandango idea, the whole the gimmick stuff by Mr. McMahon, they will, and he will give him, the briefcase and make him Mr. Money in the Bank. Well, never know, it's WWE. Anything can happen. So I don't know. Oh, I think Fandango is about to win, I think. He's gonna win it in the game right now, I think. Because only there's Wade Barrett and Fandango left in the ring, and I don't know what's gonna happen so far. All right. What the hell is Damon Sandow doing? He's just like standing. He don't even doing anything. Come on, Wade. You gotta win it. Cause plus, why do I think Wade Barrett gonna win this? Cause if you, well, all of you know that the Wade Barrett was the leader of the Nexus. Yeah, he was the leader of the Nexus. So probably, he after that he never got any really good matches. Like he had a match against Cena. He had a match against Randy Orton as well. Probably so he do deserve it's not because he's from UK and I'm from UK as well, but probably I think he do deserve it and he will be better than Dolph Ziggler. Like how Dolph Ziggler the World Heavyweight Champion, he was not really best. He didn't even have a promo for his own match, like how Randy Orton had a promo against Christian. So I don't know, Dolph Ziggler don't look big as a World Heavyweight Champion. If Wade Barrett wins the World Heavyweight Champion, he might look big. Plus, we might see some news story, I don't know, so that's what my prediction is, probably. So, probably leave a comment, do you think Wade Barrett gonna win the brief? Because kind of everyone talking about that, but seen some people saying, oh no, it's gonna be Dean Ambrose, some people are saying, no, it's gonna be Fandango. But I wish those three men have chances to win. All of other, the, nah, Cody, no, kind of, but not really. Jack Swagger, he already won, so why would they give him a game? I don't. So again, if you are watching, please, if you're gonna watch later, please leave a comment below. And this is my second live stream of the Money in the Bank. The first live stream got fucked up. YouTube problem is always some kind of shit problem. That's why I have to do this again. And I really don't know what's wrong with the YouTube. I can't really see comments yet. Maybe it's just you guys not even comment, or maybe you're not watching. Because you guys did came earlier to watch my stream and it was really awesome, but as always, YouTube have some shit problem when I'm doing the live stream. So they really fucked me up. And I hope this don't happen again. So yeah. Well, and this match probably gonna take long because it's a ladder match. Six-man ladder match. And now I know there's Antonio Cesaro as well in the match, but in WWE 13 you only can play as a six-man, not a seven-man. Plus, I don't think the guy have chances to win. I mean he's a good. I love his finisher. It's really good. It's really hard, I guess. But I don't think he do have any chances to win it. So far, I don't know. Oh, there you go. Crossroad on Dean Ambrose. And I think, oh, he. Well, probably he's not out yet. I thought he's out. Let's see if Cody Rhodes gonna beat him. Let's see if Cody Rhodes gonna, grab it. It's gonna be the Mr. Money in the Bank in the game right now, not in the real pay-per-view. Well, the real pay-per-view, you have to check out the real pay-per-view tonight. Oh shit, he's gonna get it. He's gonna get it. Come on, take it. Take it, it's your time. There you go. Cody Rhodes won. Mr. And he's a Mr. Money in the Bank now. I'm not sure this is only a prediction, but it might happen because the guy has been in WWE since a long time. So maybe it's kind of for him dream come true, something like that. I don't know, leave a prediction about that as well. So yeah, his lips kind of look weird. What the heck is wrong with his lips? I don't know. All right, guys, let's go to the next match. The next match is gonna be the World Heavyweight Championship match. And sorry if you can't hear any game sounds or anything like that, because I'm not allowed to do it. This is a live stream, so mean I have to record. I have to give a commentary, even though you guys don't like it. Still, I have to do it. Because this is the prediction, so everyone do, Tony Pizza Guy do, Tabby Emo do, 101 Game do as well, and there's a lot of the superstar. I mean, not superstar, I would say. YouTubers. Ricardo Rodriguez. Don't want to see your face, you look kind of weird. And this is gonna be the World Heavyweight Championship match. Del Rio versus Dolph Ziggler. Rematch for the Dolph Ziggler. Or I guess I know you don't want to see the entrance because it's gonna take so long to finish. He don't even do the car entrance, so you know what? Next time, next live events or something, I'm gonna have to change his entrance to a normal. Whatever, he don't do the entrance anymore. Dolph Ziggler, show off. Yep, it's gonna be the World Heavyweight Championship match. And yeah, that's all. And I am looking forward to see this match tonight. I'm not gonna miss because if you don't know yet, Del Rio is a heel now. Ziggler is a face, a kind of face, not a really, really good face, but he's kind of face now. Do you think Dolph Ziggler suck at face? I mean, he's good at being heel because he's kind of good. Show off. You know what I mean, guys? Show off. So again, my prediction for this match is that if you don't know the Dolph Ziggler, well, all of you know, Dolph Ziggler lost his World Heavyweight Championship at Payback from Del Rio because Del Rio turned heel that time. He kind of really attacked him really bad with kick after kick, kick after kick, kind of beat the heck out of him. And probably he was too injured to, start the match. And in the last kick, he lost, and probably he lost his World Heavyweight Championship because he was kind of injured and he was still had a match because he was injured before Extreme Rules. If you don't know that there was a triple threat match, Del Rio versus Ziggler versus Swagger for the World Heavyweight Championship, but he got injured and then they changed the match to one-on-one, Del Rio versus Jack Swagger, I quit match, winner will face Ziggler at Payback or something. So after he had a match against Del, I mean the match was good, but in the end we all knew that Ziggler was kind of injured, so he couldn't be the 100% that he should be. So that's why he was a bit weak, and that's why he got really, really, really bad hurt because Del Rio gave him a lot of kicks in his face. Like we all know the kick is, I mean the super kick is fake in his face. I mean if you look closely you can see the kick is so really, really fake like Del Rio do. Yeah, I don't know why, I just feel like it's a fake, that's why. Probably my prediction, as I said, I'm gonna give my prediction that Ziggler to win this because Del Rio won the World Heavyweight Championship twice this year, so there's no chances of Del Rio to retain the title. And even if he do retain the title, someone might cashing in. And if somehow Ziggler, win the World Heavyweight Championship, become the three-time World Heavyweight Champion, someone is gonna cashing in. I mean, don't you want to see someone cashing in at the same night, like they won the briefcase and they catching the scene? That will be epic. And yeah, there you go. Show off. And why his trunk look like a diaper? Like look at Del Rio, he's got different. Ziggler look like a bit, kind of like a diaper. I don't know why. I just feel like that. So yeah. All right. Again, leave your prediction if you're watching live. If you're not watching live, you're gonna watch it later. You still can leave a comment about that as well. Any of the matches you want to leave a comment. So this is our Del Rio versus Dolph Ziggler match for the World Heavyweight Championship. And this is not a real pay-per-view again, just to let you know, guys. This is not a real pay-per-view. It's a W13 prediction show where I give my prediction and where you guys should leave your opinion about the match and all that stuff. You know what I mean, guys. So yeah. All right, now I don't know how long this match is gonna take. Because it, of course, it's a World Heavyweight Championship. But one thing about World Heavyweight Championship, I don't get it. Because it's kind of not big as WWE Champion. Why don't they have promo anymore? Because when Randy Orton and Randy Orton was Christian for the World Heavyweight Championship, they had a promo. Like, when you had a promo, which means you had a big star. I mean, Big Show and Mark Henry had a promo as well. So why not Ziggler and Del Rio have the promo? I don't get that. Why do WWE do that? I mean, You know, it's better to just have the only WWE championship. That's it. Leave the whatever championship. I don't know why. I just feel like that. Because if they don't have promo for two big matches of their pay-per-views, it's no point. No point of, you know, calling that the whatever championship the same as the WWE championship. I don't know. That's what I feel. Do you think Dolph Ziggler and Ziggler should have a promo for their matches as well, like how Cena and Mark Henry have the promo? And plus, I have to say something this. I mean, if you are. Okay, if you wanted to win the Elgato Gaming Capture Card, like you can record your game right now that you can see. It's not in HD, but you know my other videos are in HD. So if you want to win that, go to my John Cena versus Mark Henry match. Yeah. And you'll be able to win the Elgato Gaming Capture Card. All you gotta do is leave a comment. And after the Money in the Bank, I will be announcing the winner. Yeah, after the Money in the Bank, because you know I wanted to check all the comments. I will pick one random comment about the match. And I will be announced a winner and I will send you Elgato Gaming Capture Card. I did that last month as well. I kind of do every single month. So probably you'll comment about that and all that. So yeah. It's gonna be epic. Elgato Gaming Capture Card are the best. I mean you can record it in HD, it really look cool. And I don't know what Ziggler is about to do. I think he's gonna give him a spear or something. Yeah, I think he's trying to give him the spear and trying to break the barricade or something. A referee counting five, getting in the ring before you get count out. Yeah, that's good. What the hell is W doing? I don't know what they're doing, man. Why is Ziggler out of the ring and trying to just break the barricade or something? He don't even have a finisher, I guess. I don't know what's going on in this match, guys. I really don't know. All right, I'm gonna go and check out if the live stream is working fine. Or not. But I guess the stream is working fine because I see live now, so it's probably fine. Are we nearly 1 hour now? I'm doing live stream since like 1 hour. Alright, Ziggler. Getting in the ring before you get count out. Oh yeah, he's gonna lose. Dolph is gonna lose his title to Ziggler. Referee counting seven. You know what? This might happen in the real pay-per-view. I think I have kind of feeling that this might happen in the stream. He might won't be able to beat him like that, so maybe count out or something. And then after that, someone come out. Maybe if Wade Barrett win the Money in the Bank, he become the Mr. Money in the Bank. He might cashing in with Ziggler and still beat him. So no point. So leave a comment about this match as well. Whenever you watch this live stream, whenever you watch this whole operation show. So yeah, let's go to our next match, the match that I cannot wait to watch, All Star Match, Money in the Bank, RVD returns. All right. Why are you taking so long? I don't get it. Oh shit, still taking so long. Yep, CM Punk, the best in the world. I'm a CM Punk guy because my channel name is the best in the world. Which I'm not a best in the world, but just my channel name is the best in the world. So probably, I don't know, I can't change it now, even if I want to. So, yep, it's gonna be 7-man ladder match, which Kane is out now, but probably someone's gonna replace him. Someone's gonna come and take his place. I don't know who, but we'll talk about that in a match. So, yep. And one more thing, RVD. He's gonna return. That's why I'm really excited. Oh, yep. Captain Charisma. Christian. Who's kind of really famous in kind of a ladder matches because, he was a partner with the Edge and all that. They were kind of, oh shit, his chest looks so hairy in the game as well. Shit. Peeps. The great white Sheamus, who kind of never won any ladder matches, so probably I don't know about him as well. All right, Seamus, we have to cut your entrance. We have to skip your entrance. We don't want to see full entrance. It might take so long. Daniel Bryan. Okay, guys, you ready? You guys ready? We're gonna do this. Yeah. Wait, we're gonna do this. I'm gonna do it. Are you guys not? Here, so I'm gonna do it. All right, 1, 2, 3. Yes. How many times? Yes. Or more? Yes. All right, finish it, man. Getting in the ring. He kind of look a bit different because now he's got a really big beard and a really long hair. So we're gonna see that in WWE 2K14. And leave a comment below if you want me. What do you want me to do in WWE 2K14? Because if you are my subscriber, gonna watch this, you know what I do in my channel. So leave a comment about what do you want me to do in WWE 2K14. It's gonna come out in October, I guess. But in the UK, it's gonna come out in November. So yeah, probably. All right, it's gonna be the next. Let's see. I think it's Randy Orton. Oh no, it's a Rob Ram Dam. Again, I'm not playing as anyone. It's a story stuff. It played by itself, so that's why I don't know who's gonna win this match. He look kind of weird. Well, it's kind of look same, so no point. Yes, Rob Ram Dam. RVD. Gonna return after fire. Can't wait to see it. Can't wait to see the crowd reaction. I mean, yeah, they're all gonna chant like RVD. RVD. They were doing when the promo came out at Payback, so probably. And I'm sorry guys, you can see the Titron is an Evolution the thingy, because I'm kind of currently working on some promo about the Randy Orton and all that stuff. So probably that's why I forgot to change it. It's still alright, it's still Randy Orton though. So again, the Kane is out of the match, so I don't know who's gonna take his place, but we'll talk about that in the match now. The match is gonna start now. Again, let's talk about everyone now in this match as well. Again, this is the match that I cannot wait. I mean, I don't care if I can't. I mean, I won't be able to if I like. I can't watch Cena versus the McMahon. I don't care about that, but I just cannot wait to see this match. Leave a comment if you cannot wait to see this match tonight. So probably again, my prediction for this match is that I'm gonna pick three guy again. I'm not gonna pick like only one guy. I'm gonna pick three guy. One is a Rob Ram Dam, of course RVD, because he's gonna return after 5 years, so of course WWE gonna give him, gonna make him Mr. Money in the Bank. Probably he did want once, and he won cashing in against Cena, and he won the WWE Championship, so probably yeah. Once RVD did beat Cena in WWE Championship match, so probably I would say he can win as well, because he's gonna return. Plus he's kind of good in this kind of matches, so probably there are chances for him to win it. And second pick, I would say. CM Punk. Now I don't know if you guys are gonna say no, CM Punk not gonna win it, because what's gonna happen in the end is CM Punk is about to win it, but then Brock Lesnar gonna come and gonna attack him or something, and then RVD gonna get a chance to win it, something like that. And my third pick is gonna be Randy Orton, because the guy had a really bad this 2 years since he's not getting any WWE title opportunity or World Heavyweight Championship title opportunity, so probably he do deserve to win the World Heavyweight Championship as well. I don't know, that's only my opinion. I know there's a Daniel Bryan as well, and now you guys are gonna say, oh, have you seen the last week? Raw, he kind of attacked Punk and Sheamus, and then he kind of kind of climbed the ladder, and he was kind of holding the minister what the hell I'm saying, briefcase, and people are, oh, he's gonna win for sure. So whenever something like that happened in the WWE, they really don't win. Yeah, like, oh, Daniel Bryan gonna win because he kind of attacked Punk and Sheamus and kind of was holding the briefcase. It doesn't mean he's gonna win it. Like, maybe there's a Randy Orton who, I mean, maybe there's a Christian who can win as well. Like, people, no one is saying that Christian is gonna win. I mean, if you're a Christian fan, then you're gonna say, oh, yeah, it's gonna be Captain Charisma who's gonna be the new Mr. Money in the Bank, because he's kind of famous in this kind of matches. And there's a Sheamus as well that. He's a former WWE champion, two-time WWE champion, and a World Heavyweight champion as well. Sorry, guys. And about Kane. Kane was attacked by the Wyatt family, them on their debut. So probably Kane was too injured to compete in this match. So I think he, Big Show gonna take his place. People are saying the Big Show gonna return, because we haven't seen Big Show since like a couple of months, 2 months or something. The Big Show might return and, join the match. Never know. So, sorry if you guys can't hear me sometime because it's a YouTube glitch. No, my problem. Sometime YouTube problem, you know. Or Randy wouldn't gonna climb. Let's see if Randy wouldn't care. Oh, sh. What the heck is going on? No one is climbing. Come on, someone climb and get grab the briefcase, man. It's not even that hard. I don't get it, man. What's going on in this match? All right, Sheamus. Again, guys. Please, leave your prediction about this match. Do you think RVD gonna make his return after Fire? Will he able to? Will he gonna be the same as we know him? Like about Fire ago? Cause he's kind of old now. RVD is a 42 right now. Yeah, I was looking for the information about him. Kind of old. He's old. He's the same age as a Kane, I guess. So probably, he's the oldest in the ring. Yeah, if Big Show joined, then he'll be the kind of same. But he's the oldest because Randy Orton, CM Punk, Sheamus, they all kind of in like 30 or something, I guess. I'm not sure about Christian. But yeah, so probably he's at 42. Can he do the stuff he used to do? You know, he's kind of really good in this kind of matches, like, you know, Extreme Rules matches, really good. And this match is gonna be kind of like Extreme Rules because, you know, no DQ, no counter. You can use anything. You can hit with a ladder. So probably, I don't know. But this is only my opinion. You know, he might be the same as he was. I mean, he might be a bit weak. And I think CM Punk is about to. Oh shit, I don't know what the heck is going on. Oh shit, there you go. Come on, Daniel Bryan. Yes. Come on, finish this match. Okay, let me check the time, guys. How long it been? I think it's been an hour or something that we're playing this. Yep, it's already been an hour that we're playing this. And there are people watching it, but I don't see any comments yet because I think I still have some problem with the YouTube probably so far. All right, come on, guys. Someone, come on. Oh, see, RVD and Randy were on top of the ladder. Okay, let's see. Oh shit, this is. What the heck was that? What kind of move was that? I didn't get it. And what is Christian doing? Don't you want to get the briefcase, mate? Come on, take it. So again, I just give my prediction. My three picks is Randy Orton, CM Punk, and RVD. The chances to win it. I don't know. You guys might say that. Oh no, Sheamus, great, right? Gonna win. I don't have any problem with Sheamus wins because even he deserved to be a WWE champion. I would say that. I know he was champion, but Randy Orton deserved more because the guy has really bad 2 years. Plus, he got divorced like 2 3 days ago. Yeah, Randy Orton has got divorced against his wife, so he's kind of really pissed off. I don't know. But WWE is script. It's not real life, so he's, you know, probably. I don't know. But again, leave a comment about that. What's gonna happen tonight? And what the what? Which match are you really like? Can't wait to see it tonight. Which is it gonna be, the 7-man all-star match? I would say 6, but it's still all-star match. Or it's gonna be the SmackDown ladder match, or Ryback versus Chris Jericho, or the main event, Cena versus Mark Henry. Now I have no idea, I think a lot of you guys are gonna say that all-star match is gonna be the epic one. And I think CM Punk, oh, what the fuck, he won't be able to grab it like that. He's gonna, oh shit, he's gonna get hurt really badly. Watch. 1, 2, and bam, there you go. Anyway, he's gonna fail. He's gonna fail. And I don't know what Daniel Bryan and Christian doing outside of the ring. They're just kind of flying. I don't know what they're doing. Okay, come on, someone grab the briefcase. What the Randy Orton doing? I don't know going on. I have no idea what's going on. All right, come on. Someone, please. Somebody please grab the briefcase. What this guy doing? They just come on. Someone is busted open. I don't know. I think it's a Daniel Bryan who's been busted open. Cause I can see a blood in the ring. Kinda. Alright, I see some comments. Rob Van Dam gonna win. Yeah, I as I said, my first pick is a Rob Van Dam. My second pick is CM Punk, and third is a Randy Orton. I mean, RKO to Sheamus. So again, it's gonna be awesome. All right, I don't know what's going on. Come on, Christian, you can do this. Oh shit, RVD's and the Christian. I have no idea what Randy Orton and Sheamus doing. All right, come on. Oh shit. Come on. Oh shit. Sheamus gonna maybe. I guess Sheamus gonna win. And or Daniel Bryan with a yes or no lock, whatever you call it, to CM Punk. Shit. They're all out, kind of. Randy Orton is out. Christian is out. I don't know what's the Rivey doing. I mean, no Rivey. What do you mean Rivey? All right, guys. Sorry. Sometime, you know, it's live, so I can't change it. I mean to say RVD, not Rivey. Rivey. What the heck, man? I'm just. Yeah, because I'm a bit tired, guys. Yeah, this is my second live stream of the Money in the Bank. That's why I'm a bit tired, and that's why I'm kind of just a bit tired, and I still have one more match to do. And they're not doing anything. Daniel Bryan got the chair as well now. What they gonna do? Are they even like wanna grab the briefcase, or they just wanna fight? All right, it's epic. Oh yes, kill switch to RVD, I guess. Yes, kill switch. He's been busted open as well. Yeah, I hope something like this happened, because I know it's not gonna happen, because it's all PG crap. No blood stuff anymore. How shit is that? What the heck is going on? Oh, it's kind of. Oh. CM Punk is tap out. No point. You gotta. Oh, shit. Yeah, whatever. Just climb the ladder and get the briefcase, mate. What are you doing? I wish I was playing this match. So I'm not playing as anyone, so. Oh, yes. Christian gonna take this. Yep, I knew it. All right, okay, guys. This what the hell Daniel Bryan doing now? No point of doing that. So probably this was only a prediction. I was not playing. So Christian won this in WWE 13, but never know what's gonna happen in real pay-per-view. But as I say, my prediction and my pick is 3: RVD, Randy Orton, and CM Punk. So we'll find out tonight at Money in the Bank. So let's go to the next match, the last and final all main event, my main event, Cena versus Mark Henry. And one more thing. Do you think Cena versus Mark Henry gonna be the main event, or is it gonna be the all-star match? It's gonna be the main event, because I'm kind of confused about it. I think it's gonna be Cena who's gonna be in the main event. I guess I can say that so far. All right, so you guys are watching it. I can see that, but I don't know. I still can't see any comments. I saw one comment that RVD gonna win, and I agree with that. That I already have chance to win this. And sorry if I'm talking so fast. Again. A lot of you guys do know me. I was doing a live stream before at like 2 hours ago. Live stream was working fine, everything was fine. In the end, something got fucked up, and I have to do the live stream again. So that's why I'm very tired. All right, Cena, we saw your entrance a million times. We don't want to see it again. So, all right, I love his entrance, Mark Henry. All right. Even I don't want to see your entrance. Kind of takes so long to do it, so probably just gonna skip the entrance. And yep, it's gonna be WWE Championship match. Yep. All right, all right. We'll just change this now. It's taking so long. It's taking so long, I don't know why. All right, now this is the last main event match, and I know you guys are gonna like, if I say like, am I really excited to see this match? Like, oh, I can't wait to see Cena versus Mark Henry. I'll say like, not really. Like, I just don't know. Like, am I really ready for to see this match at like main event? I want to say like, no. Why? Is because we saw a Mark Henry versus Cena matches a lot of time, like, you know. Probably, so probably, and it's gonna be WWE Championship match. So my prediction for this match is gonna be the Cena to retain the title and someone cashing in. And if you wanna check out my other video where Cena retained the title and then RVD cashing in, already got like 100k views or more than 100k views on that video. So go and check it out. I'll put a link below somewhere, or just go to my other video and check it out. And if you wanna see CM Punk winning the you know wins the Money in the Bank briefcase and cashing in against Cena. After he retained the title against Mark Henry, so go and check it out. They're all in my channel. They're really cool. Both got more than 150k views, so probably you might enjoy your, you know, watching that. I mean, probably. And if somehow you know Mark Henry retained the title, I mean, not what the hell. I mean, if somehow Cena lose or drop his title against Mark Henry, the still chances that Mark Henry will, you know, Mark Henry will lose championship. How? Because people are saying the Big Show is going to be the Money in the Bank, you know, taking the Kane place, and Big Show might win the briefcase, and you know, Cena might lose his championship to Mark Henry, and Mark Henry like enjoying Well, like 22nd, and then Big Show come, and then, cashing in and beat the heck out of Mark Henry and become the new WWE champion, which would be kind of epic. I mean, I don't know. This is not by my prediction, because I was kind of reading some, WWE kind of wrestling news, and the article was saying that, not me. So probably, do you think it should be Big Show who gonna take Kane place, because Kane not gonna be in the Money in the Bank? It's an all-star seven-man match, I guess. He's because already WWE.com already said that Kane is injured, and he's not gonna be in the match. So yeah. All right. So yeah, again, in my prediction that Cena, probably gonna retain the title. Now, why I'm saying that? Cause I don't know why I'm saying that Cena gonna retain the title again. Probably because Mark Henry, if you don't know, yeah, like a couple of years ago, 2 years ago, when he had a match against Randy Orton for the World Heavyweight Championship, everyone thought that Randy Orton gonna retain the title, because we thought that, oh, Randy Orton is the strongest, he's the best. But he kind of beat him, and he became the new World Heavyweight Champion. So he said the same thing to Cena as well. Like, if you have seen the Mark Henry kind of same promo as CM Punk when he did a couple of years ago, remember? Like, kind of, he was tweeting everything, like, oh, he's gonna retire and all that crap. He came out kind of cry and all that. He's like, oh, he's going home, he's gonna, probably all that shit. I was like, oh shit, he's gonna retire for sure. But then in the end, Cena came. Even Cena, he will give his title, like, oh, hold the title and just feel like you are the WWE champion. And then Mark Henry, like, oh no, to be a champion, you gotta be the champion and you own the championship, not get it like this. Then he gave it back. Cena came in the ring to kind of hug him. But then Mark Henry just gave him the world's strongest slam. And probably that was like, oh shit, that's. And he told me, right? He's like, oh shit. And then I knew that it's gonna be Mark Henry versus Cena. Well, it was not Mark Henry versus Cena, it was Cena versus Daniel Bryan. Not Bryan. I have so many problems with the words today. I'm a bit tired, that's why. I mean to say Daniel Bryan, because but Daniel Bryan kind of was injured. Yeah, he was injured at Payback. Then he had a match against Randy Orton next night at Raw. He was injured and they had to change the match, I guess. And they gave the Mark Henry a match. So probably, yeah. So leave a comment. Do you think Mark Henry gonna give Cena World's Strongest Slam and gonna become the new WWE champion and the first time WWE champion on his career? He won the World Heavyweight Championship. He won the ECW WWE Championship, but he never ever won WWE Championship in his 50 years career in WWE. So probably, maybe he do deserve, and I think WWE should give him a one chance. Cena won like a 13th time. Okay, if Mark Henry win once, that's all right. The guy needed, okay, 15 years of work with WWE, and if you don't become the WWE champion, that's so shit, and really shit. I mean, there are a lot of superstars who was in WWE for long, but they never became the champion. Like Jerry Lawler, he never was a champion so far. Booker T, who was only a five-time ECW champion. I mean, not WCW champion, which has been World Heavyweight Champion, but never WWE champion, I guess. So I don't know. But you guys can leave a comment about that and all that other stuff. Now, I don't know how long this match is gonna take place. I think we already about like hour and something, 15 minute, and kind of all right. It's not a really long live stream. I was about to do the really long live stream, cause but now I'm a bit tired to this live stream stuff, cause I did already once. This is the second time I'm doing it. That's why I'm a bit tired. So yeah, but I guess we all know what's gonna happen in this match. What is going on? I don't get it. Yeah, we all know Cena never give up. And now I don't hate Cena, and not that I like him or anything like that. But probably he's just being so shit. Cause why does he get title opportunity after title opportunity? Like, he's got like, he's like 11-time WWE champion, right? And 2-time World Heavyweight champion. So altogether 13-time world champion. And they are the superstar who deserve it. Like, really, they are the superstar. I mean, he should give them a chance as well. Probably, Cena is the face of WWE, and probably they won't. I don't hate the guy, just I hate the idea that he always in the main event for some reason. Probably if it was a Cena versus Punk, I would love to see that. But Mark Henry versus Cena, I don't see really good match, but it'll be all right. But yes, my prediction and my thought that Cena retain the title, but at the same time, I think Cena need to give the title to Mark and drop the title and do something. Or maybe someone gonna cash in and something like that. I don't know. It's only my prediction, not a real pay-per-view. There's a W13 prediction, not a real match or anything like that. So yeah. All right, guys. If you're still not watching it, if you're gonna watch it later on, please leave a prediction. And again, let me just tell you for your information, this is not a real pay-per-view. It's a W13 prediction. Show where I give my prediction, my opinion, and later on, when you see the video, you guys like, oh, it should be like this, not like that, and all that prediction show. So all right, so you get it now, because a lot of you guys do complain like, I want to see the real pay-per-view, but you know, WWE like won't let their pay-per-view be in YouTube. But there are some guys who's really clever. And they do really upload a whole show. I don't know how they do it, cause like look at my live stream like 2 hours ago. I did Money in the Bank. I had just like CM Punk theme song for like 2 seconds, and I got like copyright strike. So I don't know. I just get confused sometimes. How they do it? So yeah, they still don't have a finisher. I can't believe it, mate. Oh yes, eh. It's over. Let's look over to me. Pin him. Why? What the hell? Pin him. One, two, and there you go. So, yeah, kind of my prediction right in the main event that Cena returned the title, but then someone, you know, kind of, you know, just come. Maybe if it's RVD who won the Money in the Bank briefcase, and you know, he might just care. Cashing in on the Cena and become the new champion. RVD already beat Cena for the W Championship a couple of years ago. CM Punk, yeah, there are chances that he win, he will cash as well. And Randy Orton, yep, if he win, he will cashing in at the same line as he said in the interview like last week. So probably, I hope you enjoyed the live stream. And again, if you wanna win Elgato Gaming Capture Card to record your PS3 Xbox 360 game, go to my John Cena vs. Mark Henry match, and you'll get all the information how to win and all that stuff. So I hope you enjoy this show. And sorry if you didn't, because I'm a bit tired because I did live stream twice. So probably the commentary was not the best, but I'll try next time. Not to do all this stuff. So I hope you enjoy it. Hit the like, hit the subscribe, and I will see you all later.